Homelessness does not have a face. It is not always recognizable. Just because it is not blatantly visible on every street corner does not mean that it is non-existent in our community.
One thing that we often forget to appreciate and understand is that homelessness is a trauma. Whether it's a war veteran or a doctor, you know, it can happen to all of us. And so many of us are living one paycheck away.
With the conflict in Afghanistan drawing to a close, a larger number of returning veterans will face an increasingly difficult job market in this struggling economy.
Homelessness isn't a person. I try and say, you know, persons who are experiencing homelessness as opposed to homeless people. Mainly because, you know, it's not who you are. It is a situation. Sometimes it lasts longer than others, but people can be judged for their current situation, whether or not they're homeless or whatever it may be.
But there are many factors that contribute to one's homeless episode.
Statistics suggest that 1/4 of the homeless population are veterans. Quite a number of these people that are homeless have other issues that are causing them to be homeless that we need to address.
My platoon basically did a convoy support. One of the rooms, a grenade came in, and I yelled, grenade. And by the time I was in the room, I was, you know, more than halfway in, so I just saw an opening and I took it and didn't realize that I was on the second floor and then fell from the top of a second story building. That's how I injured my back. I've never ever had a problem with alcohol, drugs, or anything throughout my life until I met OxyContin. And I think it was because I was on it for so long. I was on it for over a year. And they just kept handing it out to me in the Army while I was deployed. I don't know if I had anything to do with the depression, but I think maybe at the time I was using that as a coping method.
Very common for those that suffer with post-traumatic stress disorder, other issues, anxiety, depression, to mask those with drugs and alcohol.
You know, I was diagnosed later on with PTSD. I never really want to admit to that. It's hard to explain. I'm just, I know I'm different. You know, people around me that have knew me before, you know, they know that I'm just not the same guy.
They say over 50% of those newly returning veterans are suffering from some level of depression or anxiety.
Fox Valley, fortunately, is very proactive in the idea of TBIs and traumatic brain injuries. And so there's some great support groups in the area for those sorts of things and really working to try and get people connected to relevant services.
I think the real challenge and focus for us needs to be what we do about those issues to either keep them from becoming homeless or getting them out of a state of homelessness.
I had some money at the time. I stayed in motels for about a month. That was just really dumb because it was real expensive for, you know, what you're getting. And then basically when I had nowhere to go, I didn't know what to do. There one night, you know, I would just basically walk the streets.
On days and nights where the wind chill is negative 30, people won't last long out there. And so it might seem extreme to say it, but it is a life and death situation.
There's a number of organizations that I've mentioned out there that help veterans that are in a state of homelessness, and oftentimes it's very difficult for us to get the word out to all the veterans that there's these services available. So a lot of times we rely on word of mouth, veterans helping veterans, I call it.
When you get out of the military, there is a program that you have to go through. You know, they give you too much information to begin with, and most of it is stuff that really doesn't make sense in the end.
Could the wealth of information given to veterans as they leave the military create unnecessary challenges for reintegration back into civilian life?
all of these different programs that help, you know, veterans. I mean, it'd be nice to have a pamphlet that, you know, everything that, you know, is offered, and it gets updated, you know, once a year, of, you know, that it even has nonprofits in there, you know, even a telephone number that you can call to get a hold of these people. And
preventing someone's homeless episode is around $200 to provide assistance, whereas someone coming into the shelter and being sheltered for a month costs upwards of $700-$800. That impacts us all as a community through taxes, through supporting those services, all those different things. And more importantly, when someone's here, they're receiving case management, supportive services, and they're given that opportunity to grow.
Outagamie County has started up, last year, started up a veterans court program. And we found that a lot of these veterans that are getting into legal troubles aren't doing it because they're defective people. They're acting out because they haven't gotten treatment. So this has been an amazing way to capture and if you will, force these people that need treatment into a course of treatment.
There is a boot camp to enter the military, but there is no such program to re-enter civilian life. The government is currently working to establish a reverse boot camp for veterans, which will help them reintegrate. As of right now, they are hoping to implement this plan by the end of 2013.
Before I joined the Army, you know, I was making good money, you know, just being able to live that middle class lifestyle. Just having a, you know, bad experience of being in this position during this time of the economy. It's not a good thing, obviously. I do want to go back to school and I mean, it's the only way I'm going to, you know, get the type of job that, you know, is gonna pay well. That's where my long-term goal is.